DJ Sean.
My name is Lady Gaga.
What's up, y'all? It's the Black Eyed
Peas, and you're watching Desi Hits.
Arun and P here with another five rounds, and if this week's artist was available in the supermarket, he'd be in the organic section. 100% real and natural talent, this Taio Cruz!
So Taio, today we're going to go five rounds. That basically means five groups of questions about five different topics. Are you ready?
I am absolutely ready, let's make this happen.
The first topic is the music.
Taio, what a crazy couple of years it's been for you. Massive hits with Break Your Heart, Dynamite and Dirty Picture. Do you look back and then think, wow, that happened really, really fast?
The way that it happened in America, I definitely feel like that it was a roller coaster ride. And last year was absolutely insane.
And you've been part of a lot of collaborations, Kylie, Kesha, Tinchy, Ludacris.
Yes.
What's been your most memorable one?
They're all very, very memorable. Kesha is a big ball of fun and she's just a very sweet girl and just crazy. Ludacris is very, very wise, has been in the game for a while and, you know, was definitely ready to impart knowledge on me, which was great. And Kylie Minogue, I recorded in my house, made her a cup of tea.
Now, the first time a very young Mr. Cruz first came on our radar, it was in 2003 when you were on the Rainfall track with Nathan Sawney. Are you looking to hook up with any other Asian artists?
I'm completely open to working with people who just make great music. Obviously, your boy Jay Sean is rocking it and doing big things across the globe, so I would love to work with him.
Well, we look forward to that Taio Cruz-Jay Sean collaboration.
That'll be dope.
And we've noticed that you're quite a modest guy when it comes to being on camera. But let's face it, you're a superstar now, loads of hits. Do you remember that day when you woke up in the morning, you looked in the mirror and thought, I'm the f***ing man? It must have been a day when that happened.
I never really think of it like that.
But this section is called If I Were President. And it's basically about if you were the head honcho in the UK.
So first up, which one of your songs would you make the unofficial national anthem of the UK?
I'd have to make Dynamite the unofficial anthem of the UK, just because it's all about having fun and being uplifted, and I think that's what a country should have as their national anthem.
And if you had to work with the British national anthem as we have it now?
I love the national anthem, just the musicality of it, so I would just, you know, sample it, put some drums underneath it, it'll be dope. Get the Queen to feature.
Sounds good. A little rap.
Yeah, you know, she could drop a couple verses.
Now we know you got a girlfriend.
I don't right now.
Oh, you don't?
No,
okay,
well, I'm
who would you?
Right
this
now.
Is perfect. You're the president of the UK. Who would yes. be your leading lady? And what a mistake your girlfriend made. We can do short-term contracts. You can have a couple just for 3 months, work it.
Oh, just okay, cool. Yeah. So I can just switch them out.
Yeah. Who would be part of the harem?
I'd have to throw in Megan Fox there. Uh-huh. I kind of like Zoe Saldana.
Yeah.
There is who else is in there?
Any older women you're throwing in? I mean, an older head. More experienced head.
More experienced head. Salma Hayek?
Yeah.
Maybe.
Oh, so not going as far as Helen Mirren?
No, I'm not going as far as Helen Mirren.
And if you had to pass one law, a brand new law, what do you think it would be?
If I could pass a law or like spread some magic, it would be to eradicate greed, because I think that is the main issue. I don't want to eradicate competition, because I think competition is healthy, but I think just greed is what generally makes a lot of the problems in society.
Lastly, and probably your most important task, would you do us all a favour and deport Simon Cowell?
Yes, no problem.
The third round is the UK invasion of the US.
See, the thing is, lots have tried, and only a few have succeeded. There's yourself, Jay Sean, Susan Boyle. A lot of big guns haven't managed it. What do you think the trick is to break in the US?
Well, number one, I think nowadays it's easier, just because I think you're not as reliant on the politicians, if you will, to get your music out there. So you can put your music online and it's immediately available to the entire world. And I think a lot of my fans knew about me before, you know, I actually was released in America, and that definitely helped, because even the label was quite surprised as to the speed at which Break Your Heart sold.
Well, you've got your finger on the pulse. Who's likely to be next?
I think Tiny Temper's going to do his thing.
Yeah,
I think that for me, I wouldn't normally think British rappers can make it in America, but I think that his delivery and the clarity of what he's saying it will be accessible to Americans, because Americans will generally be like, I don't know what he said there, I don't really understand the accent, but he's, you know, he enunciates and it's quite clear, so I think he could work, and his music is just amazing as well. Everybody gonna say
UK. Round four is called The Moneymaker. Now, Taio, as we're in the boardroom, this section is all about you becoming Taio the Mogul and filling those pockets with extracurricular activities.
Nice, okay.
And we know you've already started the whole fashion thing. You've got your accessories, you've got the rock star shades, everyone's wearing them.
Yes.
Everyone wants to wear them.
Yeah.
You're hopefully going to branch into watches, clothing, etc. Apart from that, where else are you trying to spread the rock star brand?
We have the watches that have been designed, and we're hopefully going to launch those this summer. And the bags collaboration as well is also happening.
Well, away from being the front man, you're also in great demand as a songwriter.
Yeah.
When you're singing with someone and you're writing those songs and something fantastic comes into your head, do you ever think, you know what? I'm gonna save that for myself.
The only times I do that is if I sing something out and then they don't immediately, you know, take to it. So if I sing out a hook, I'm like, I'm only gonna break you. And they're like, yeah, that's okay. And I go, okay, cool. I'll just keep that one in my dictaphone for myself later.
And now that you're single,
yes.
You exclusively told us that just a little while ago.
Yes.
Would you ever write a song for an artist just so you can get a little closer to her, even if she couldn't sing?
I'm absolutely down, yes. Let's make that, well. I'll definitely have a meeting.
You're that kind of man. The last round is Heartbreaker.
Valentine's Day has just passed, and yes, unfortunately Arun and I were twiddling our thumbs at home. We didn't have no dates.
Yeah.
And so this section is really about changing things so that next year we're not suffering the same way and we're out with the girls, basically.
Okay.
So kicking it off, we heard you like drawing.
I do.
Should we be pulling out the paints and the pencils? Is that what we're doing wrong, that sort of feminine touch?
Do you know what it is? I think girls are attracted to confidence, so just be yourself.
Do you reckon that we need to get into the music industry ourselves just to get some of that, you know, groupie love?
Okay, so now groupie love is very different to Valentine's Day. If you want to get some groupie love, absolutely, just write a smash hit song, go to the club.
And become rock stars ourselves, yeah.
Yeah, I think you could do that. Okay. I think you could absolutely do that.
Lastly, should I become a heartbreaker and use that sort of treat them mean, keep them keen policy?
It just depends on the type of girl you're looking for, really.
Anything.
Just anything.
Well, it sounds like there's no hope for us. Anyway, that was five rounds. Arun and P and Taio Cruz, give us five.
Thank you, sir. Absolutely. Thank you.
Hi, this is Katrina Kaif.
Hi, what's up? I'm Enrique Iglesias.
Hey, you guys. I'm Nicki Minaj, and you're checking out DesiHits.com.